Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today I'm really excited to be doing a tag video as a collab. Today's video, I'm collabing with Victoria from RareBeautyEnvy here on YouTube. She has such a cute little channel. I could literally listen to her, like, talk all day. That's the one thing about, like, I don't know, podcasts, YouTube channels. If you have a nice voice, like, that's the biggest draw for me, and I love her voice. I love listening to her talk. She does some great little hauls. She does like get ready with me. She's doing some project pans now as well, which I'm very excited to follow along with. So if you haven't checked out her channel, I will have one of her videos linked up above, and I will have some of her videos along with her channel, and then once this video of hers goes live, I'll go ahead and post that in the description box as well. The tag we're going to be doing today is the colorful makeup tag, and I first found this tag from Angelica Nyquist, and the tag's original creator is Anya, so I will have Angelica's and Anya's videos and channels linked down below as well. I know Victoria, one of her New Year's resolutions for her channel is to be a little bit more consistent, and one of my New Year's resolutions for my channel was to do a few more collabs, and I thought this would be just like kind of the perfect way for us both to get moving on our goal. So thank you so much, Victoria, for collabing with me, and I can't wait to do this tag and see what you answer to. Before we jump into the tag, don't forget to give this a thumbs up if you like these kinds of tag videos, and if you haven't and you'd like to, hope you will consider subscribing so that you're notified whenever I post a new video every single Monday through Friday. So the tag has 9 questions all about colorful makeup. The first question is, when and why did you start using color? For the longest time, I was afraid of color. I didn't wear lipstick for the first couple years I was into makeup, and I didn't get into colorful eyeshadow for a long time. If you missed the video I did all about my very first eyeshadow palette, I'll throw that up in the cards, but it was a very neutral palette, and after that I stuck to neutral palettes for a while until this palette. Of course, Modern Renaissance. This was the first time I had ever touched a red eyeshadow or an orange eyeshadow, because I remember hearing like an old wives' tale or something about how red eyeshadow makes you look tired. And as someone who already had bags under her eyes, as someone who's perpetually tired, I didn't want that. So I had never looked at really colorful eyeshadow until this palette. This was the very first time I did anything touching color. And I went and I did this look. It's a very older picture on my Instagram, but I was so proud of that look. It took me way too long to do. But that was the first time that I really played with color and shared it. So I did share it with like my friends and family, and I got a lot of really good feedback from that. Question number 2 is, what is your favorite color to wear? Now, I'm going to break this into lipstick and eyeshadow, because I don't think these are like specific to just eyeshadow, though I think of a lot of them are going to apply to eyeshadow. So my favorite color to wear for lipstick is actually red lipstick. I love the way red lipstick looks on me. It looks great with my complexion and my undertones. I just don't, here's the thing, I don't have a whole lot of occasions to wear it, other than like just for filming or just for something else. I would have worn it today, but I'm wearing like a yellowy look today and I didn't want to look like McDonald's, okay? So I love red lipstick, and I used to be afraid of it too. I was so afraid of red lipstick, and then whenever I wore it, it just looked so good. And pink also looks really good on me, even though I'm more inclined to wear red than I am pink. But I love red lipstick, and for eyeshadow, of course, it's green eyeshadow. I love green eyeshadow way too much. I don't understand why. I don't know how I really got into it. I just love the way green looks. And I think with my brown eyes, they pop with the green shadow. And I think it's so pretty. What is your go-to colorful combination? So this one I thought I could tie into my Pan That palette, because the look that I'm wearing right now, it's not as brightly colorful, but it's still colorful. So I'm using 3 of the shades for my Pan That palette, and it's been kind of my go-to look so far with my palette. I used the shade Edge, this like yellow, all like in my transition and on my lower lash line. And then I packed the shade New Wave, this kind of more orangey shade, all over my lid and brought it up just a little bit. And then I took the green glimmer shade Electric, and I used that all over the lid. And it's a really quick look, really easy, looks stunning. And this is work appropriate for me, so I can actually wear this to work. This is about as colorful as I can get for work. I might be able to go a little bit darker and do a little bit more smoky, but for the most part, this is about as colorful as I'll get for like the office. Some other color combinations I really like. I really like seeing yellow with green. I think that's really cute, like a really nice yellow transition color with green all over the lid. I also really like seeing red and purple. I think that looks stunning. That's more of like a dramatic smoky look, but gorgeous. I also really like seeing orange and red. So you can get some really nice color combinations there, along with the millions of sunset palettes that are out there. There are some great ones in the original Modern Renaissance palette, including Real Gar, Burnt Orange, Raw Sienna. These are some gorgeous, gorgeous shades. Question number four are, who are some of your favorite influencers to follow that inspire you color-wise? There are two main influencers. The first one is LS. She has some of the most gorgeous, colorful, like, editorial looks. So I follow her on Instagram too, and sometimes she'll post pictures of the looks, and I'll like look at them and try to study them and see like how she does it. And just, they're gorgeous. They're stunning. She works with the color, and it's incredible what she can do. So she really inspires me. And Angelica Nyquist, she also obviously loves color, and she comes up with some really creative looks with palettes that I have that I wouldn't have even thought of. So those are the two influencers that really inspire me to reach for more colorful palettes and for more colorful looks. Question number five is, what do your family and friends think of your colorful makeup style? So for the most part, I will say that Monday through Thursday when I'm working in the office, it's not too crazy. So my family doesn't really touch too much on it, but when I do a very colorful look, they'll notice and they'll say, oh, that looks really cute today, or that looks really pretty, what are you wearing today? I've never gotten like a, why are you wearing that, you know, that kind of thing. And I think it's because I approached color very, very slowly, and I kind of built up to it because I was just neutral for so long. I went with some kind of neutrally color looks like this right here, and then I built up to like that red eyeshadow look that I did, built up to green looks that I did. So I think it gave them time to kind of get used to it. But as far as I know, that's the kicker, isn't it? As far as I know, they obviously all support me. They really like seeing whatever I come up with for the day. I actually have a coworker who, she's the sweetest thing ever. I call her work mom just because she's a little bit overbearing, but in such like the sweetest way ever. She's adorable. And every morning she'll come over and like look at my makeup and she goes, oh my god, your eyeshadow is really pretty today. Or, oh, look at your blush. Or, ooh, look at your lipstick. Like, it's actually adorable. And so she'll come up and kind of interrogate me about what I'm wearing. So I've only gotten positive responses from it, and I'm kind of glad. Actually, no, that's, I have gotten one like, oh my god, what are you wearing, but that was because I was wearing a foundation that looked horrible on me, not for my look. So that's the only time I really got called out. Question number six is there a color that you're looking for a perfect formula in? And I feel like I'm not looking for like a perfect formula, because I've tried out so many formulas, and I have a few that I really do keep going back to and enjoy. A couple of them, I pulled out a few palettes just to let you know like what I'm reaching for. The first one is a Smoke Sessions palette from Melt Cosmetics. The greens in here are gorgeous. The golds in here are gorgeous. I'm still planning to do like a two looks one palette and a full review of this. I know it's a little bit late, but with my palette reviews, I don't like to rush them. I really like to test it out thoroughly and give you guys a full review of the product. A palette I did do a full review on and loved, this is the Good Sport palette by ColourPop. One of the best things they've come out with. Even if they come out with 10 things a week, one of them is bound to be okay, right? This is a great fall palette. I love it. And the green shimmer up here, it's one of the most unique shimmers and green shadows I've ever seen. And I adore that. So I think that might have been like the white whale of green shimmers that I was looking for, because I adore that shimmer. Another palette that I did a video on that I've been obsessed with is from Juvia's Place. This is the Tribe palette, and I think this might be the closest thing to a near perfect palette for me, because I've got my greens, I've got some neutrals, I've got an orange. The only thing I probably would have replaced is like this blue shimmery shade right here. I might have thrown in another green, just because the shade down here, while it looks blue, it really is a green. So I would have liked to have a green shimmer to kind of tie this all together, but I still love this palette. And I was so inspired by different looks, because at first I saw the palette and I was like, what am I gonna do with that? But then literally, 8 million ideas popped into my head, and I could have kept using it on and on and on and on and on. The last palette that is a little bit intense. This is from Natasha Denona, and this is one of her big palettes. This is the green brown palette, and I still have the sheet with all the shade names on it. I still haven't taken the film off of the mirror. I don't know why. So this is the green-brown palette right here. I was actually seriously considering whether I wanted to include this as part of like my year-long project pan, but it's huge. I don't know if I'll ever really hit pan on anything. But the green shimmers in here are absolutely stunning. This row right here is some of the cutest like inner corner highlights that I've ever seen. Is it worth the crazy price point? Debatable. Is it worth it for me, someone who's obsessed with green eyeshadow and wants to keep experimenting with all the formulas she can? Yeah. The next question, question 7, is would you rather wear a neutral lip color and colorful eyeshadow or colorful lip color and neutral eyeshadow for the rest of your life? That's super simple. I would totally do a nude lip and colorful eyes. Because that's kind of my go-to whenever I do an intense eye look. I always go for a neutral lip. So I would consider this a neutral lip. I'm just wearing a Wet n Wild gloss. I actually mixed two of the shades together. These are their High Shine lipsticks in Caught You Bare Naked, mixed with the shade Cedar Later. Pun. So I put on the darker shade first, and then I lightened it up a little bit with this. And it's just a nice, neutrally comfortable lipstick, and I think it just matches colorful looks so much better. Like, I do like wearing colorful lipsticks, but if given the choice, 100% I would go for the crazy colorful eyeshadow and a neutral lip. Question number 8, we're getting into the deep questions now, is what is your opinion on glitter? Do you love it? Do you hate it? Why? See, for me, this is all about the type of glitter. When it comes to easy to apply, like, liquidy glitters, like I'm talking about the Stila glittering glows and anything similar, I love it. Those are so easy to apply. They look gorgeous. They add this pop, and I literally have like a drawer full of different colors of that formula because I love it so much. It's the easiest way to add a pop of just oomph to any look. When it comes to like a loose pigment, I hate it. Cannot work with loose pigment. I've tried. I use glitter glues. I just make a mess. And why would I go through all this trouble, make a mess, get glitter all over my face, when there's such an easier way to apply glitter that just looks so much better? And then I don't like pressed glitters either for the same reason. Like, I'll do shimmers and, you know, pressed shadows, but when it's a pressed glitter, you're asking for a mess. And our last question for this tag, question number 9, is what is your go-to colorful eyeshadow palette at the moment? Now, I feel like I kind of already gave this away with talking about my Pan That palette, because my Pan That palette is very colorful. This is the Subculture palette. This is going to be my go-to palette for all of 2019. I've been working a lot. I've been looking up a lot of tutorials, and so far, I've actually been able to jump in and experiment with every shade except for Axis. I feel like that's gonna be my challenge shade in this palette. It's like a really, really deep blue that doesn't really blend out the best. But for every other shade, I've done looks that I've been really happy with. So this has been my go-to palette for the past couple of weeks as I've been building up to my Pan That palette and as I continue in 2019. But if we're talking about anything apart from my Pan That palette, my other recent go-to palette would then have to be the Tribe palette. Ever since I did that video, I've still been reaching back for this palette. I love the variety in here. I love the shades. That being said, majority of this is too colorful for me to wear to work, but whenever I work from home or on the weekends, I'm reaching for this palette too. It's just so pretty. Alright, and that is the entire colorful makeup tag. Thank you so much, Victoria, for doing this tag with me. And I hope you guys like this video. Let me know down below what your answers to these questions are. And if you do want to do this tag video, I tag you. I want to see your answers to this video. Let me know in the comments, DM me on Instagram. Let me know when you post it because I would love to see it. Thank you for watching, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.